Hello everyone, excuse for the noise that you're hearing, but I'm looking at something right now on my computer. Today, March 22nd, Rob Ford passed away. As most of you know, he is the 64th mayor of Toronto from 2010 to 2014, and it's sad because all over the world, millions upon millions of people are dying due to debilitating disease, heart disease being the number one cause, and then there's of course cancer, strokes, diabetes, and so forth. Now, even though I really didn't hate the person, the man, Rob Ford, there were many things that over the years that we just, people, and especially me, thought that were very funny of him doing videos, and there was parodies, and then there was cartoons of him, and all these things that, of him. But this video is not really about him. It is about the fact that we're all dying, even if it's not physically, but many people are dying physically. But spiritually, we're dying, and ethically, we're dying within ourselves because of the fact that we're causing harm, suffering, pain to other beings. And we all know in our bones that whenever we do something to another being, it comes back to harm us. And a lot of us have been, all of us have been conditioned since birth to eat a certain way and to view the world in a certain way that we think everything that we're doing is natural, normal, and necessary, and that when we succumb to any kind of debilitating disease, it's just normal, natural, necessary that we'll be getting these diseases. And if we're being violent to non-human animals, it's normal, natural, necessary because everyone's doing it. And we think that it's genes, our health has to do with genes, or has to do with old age, or has to do with some sort of external factor. And the story, I thought that same thing when I was younger. I thought that no, I'm not causing any suffering and violence, and no, it wasn't me. It was everything to do with the external, with the outer world. And how wrong was I? I was very wrong, because after many years of trying to figure out and trying to understand, why do we have the problems that we do on this planet? Why do we have all the devastations and all the violence and all the suffering and all the killing? And why do we have all the wars? And why do we have all these conflicts that don't have to happen? And the answer is simply that we need to look deep at what we're doing at every waking moment of our lives. What are we doing? And we need to rectify our behaviors, change our behaviors to align with what we truly believe in our heart, which is love and peace and compassion for all. And we really do believe that. The average human would not go out and harm or kill another being. And that is why I probably 99% of the world does not commit direct harm. If you think about it, direct harm, no one goes out and kills a pig or kills a dog and eats the being. No one. And when we really think about it, we are decent human beings on the outer level. But when we look at our actions, when we look at our food choices, when we look at our clothing choices, when we look at our product choices, when we look at the way we live and the way we think and the way we talk and the way we associate with others and with nature and so forth, we are not that loving and caring if we really think about it deep down. But it's not that we're not loving and caring. We just lost that love. We've lost that compassion. We've lost that inner wisdom for understanding and truth. And until we reawaken the lost love, and actually that's really funny to go on this point, the lost love, because my upcoming book is called The Lost Love, and how we essentially lost that love that we once had as children. Because when we're born, I believe, truly believe, when we're born compassionate, loving, caring, and we don't judge anyone. We don't judge a person if they have different skin color than us. We don't judge if a being is a different species. We don't judge if, we don't compete. We don't do any of these violent actions. But as time goes on, we start learning these behaviors. Basically, from day one, we start learning these behaviors. And it comes to a point where we need to evaluate, we need to change our practices and our actions to align with our thoughts and beliefs. And we truly do believe one thing, and then we believe another thing. For example, our world, our culture, churches, and all religious institutions, educational institutions, in fact, all institutions, for that matter, have taught us to believe one thing, to believe that eating certain animals is okay, and caring for other animals is okay, and loving thy neighbor is okay. But we all know one thing. We all know that kindness and compassion and love is what truly we need to be in order to heal the world, in order to heal ourselves, and to be nonviolent. But we are violent at every meal, and we think that it's normal, natural, necessary. We need to wake up. When are we ever going to wake up? When are we ever going to reawaken that love within ourselves? Until we stop using, until we stop seeing animals as property, non-human animals as property, all beings for that matter as property, things will just dissolve. But once we start seeing animals as sentient beings that deserve the right to live on this planet, then the only logical thing will be is that we'll stop using them, we'll stop abusing them, we'll stop torturing them, we'll stop killing them, we'll stop using them for anything. And once we do this, then everything else falls away. All the other violence towards humans falls away. All the other violence towards the environment falls away. Because we cannot be compassionate and loving towards one creature, towards a group of creatures, and not expect to do the same thing to others. If we are violent and deceitful and cause suffering to non-human animals, what do you think we're going to do to humans? And so, even though it might seem on the outside that we're kind and loving and caring towards other humans, we're really not, because deep down inside, we have all this anger, we have all this built-up emotion, negative emotions within ourselves that eventually, I mean, look at how many people around the world are abusing their spouses and children. They're going out and they're causing harm to animals, they're causing harm to their communities. We got all kinds of debilitating diseases. We have mental diseases. I mean, the list just goes on and on and on. Wars and suffering, environmental devastations and economic issues and problem after problem after problem. Why can't we just solve the core of the issue, which is to get rid of what is causing the suffering and the devastation to begin with, which is eating animals and animal foods. And once we do that, we'll start to understand and make the connection for a more ethical and spiritual and compassionate world for ourselves and for all other beings on this planet. So we need to reawaken for people that are still in this trance and still in this closed mindset box with blinders on. That's not our fault. We've been conditioned and born in this culture that is violent, and we need to unprogram ourselves to be compassionate, loving, caring, and to reevaluate everything in our lives. I want to thank you for joining me and for listening. And don't forget, do your part. The only way to really solve all these problems that we're faced with on this planet and to live more joyful and happier lives is to be vegan, is to one step closer to being in the Garden of Eden. Thank you, everyone. Much love.